You good, bro?
Just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Today it's week four and we've got what should be a great one here between the Detroit Lions and the Carolina Panthers. It's 3-0 versus 2-1, a good early season battle as we're underway in week four. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. This drive out on the ground. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven past the 30 to the 32. But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. That one, a first down pickup of eight. The Panthers hit 3-0 here in the month of September. And they're coming out a pretty good roll here. Winners of three straight.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
He'll find his man, Terrace Marshall, complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
And partner, they're locked in man coverage out left and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. And he's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. So it's the big left tackle who gets tagged with a hold.
And sometimes you're actually executing the block well and he starts to slip off of you and instinctively you reach out and grab him. And when it's done like that, it's often seen by the official and called.
Here's Corral. He'll fight his man, LaVisca Chenault. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Ahead of the chains now, second and two. First carry for the Oklahoma State man, Chuba Hubbard. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense? The next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. try and run for this with Hubbard.
He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
Just a simple run play there on third and one, but this D was up to the challenge and stopped him, bringing up fourth down.
Eddie Pinheiro on now. And this will be a 45-yard attempt. This is up and good from Pinheiro. And the Panthers stay claim to a 3-0 lead. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Taken in by Jamison Williams. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were excellent a week ago in that victory over Indianapolis.
And that's not the half of it. They forced 7 turnovers in that game, and I know we always talk about turnovers coming in bunches once you force the first one, but 7? That seems almost impossible, but we watched it happen.
They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Come on. Hey. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down. Now, look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched it more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
Right back to him on first down. And now the rookie's free. 20. Touchdown, Detroit.
Bottom line, when you play a runner with these talents, you've got to be able to wrap up and get him on the ground. Or the first person who gets there, hold him up long enough for the next wave to get there and get him down. Otherwise, he will continue downfield and find pay dirt.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And last time, able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
4 yards the pickup, first down.
2nd and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On 2nd down, here's a run with Hubbard. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
And he'll get what he can up the middle, 3 yards. That'll bring up second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Over the middle, complete. It's Hubbard. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 29-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover it before he gets going?
They had to settle for 3 last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in 6. In good position, 1st and 10. And they'll run on 1st down with Hubbard. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 12 more yards there and another 1st down. All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has 3 options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. A 1st down throw here for Corral. Oh, and this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's 2nd down.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. So after the incompletion on 1st, now 2nd and 10. A give up the middle, Hubbard. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
And the Lions going with an extra DB here on 3rd down. On 3rd down, Corral. Rifling one complete into the hands of Marshall. That he won't quite make it. He needed 6. He got about 5. 4th down.
I thought they might take a shot down the field, but instead they ran a little drag route there. I think they were hoping he could catch it and run away from the defender. But a really good job keeping the play in front of them, and they force a 4th down.
The kick by Pinero is good. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So it was 4th and 1 down in the red zone, but they elect to take just the 3.
And I'm a little surprised that that's how they decided to play it, that they didn't go for it there. But sometimes just take those 3 points and put them in your pocket. I just have one question for you, partner.
Okay.
Hip pocket or back pocket?
Offense ready to kick off their next drive. The offense coming back out here. Plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, partner, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. It's a touchdown, Detroit!
We saw so much of this last year at the college level, but there you go, his 1st rushing touchdown as an NFL quarterback.
And with the speed he has,
We certainly know it won't be his last, because that's something that aided him very well, as you mentioned, at the college level. It's something he's going to carry over, and they'll make it a big part of their offense.
Point after, right down the middle, and the lead is up to 8. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They're kind of searching for that magic elixir. You know, they're moving the football a little bit, but not with any great consistency.
I love that term you just used, elixir, right?
Old school.
Old school. I love that, because you don't want to put too much pressure on your defense as well. All right, if you're kicking field goals, that's great, but your defense has to keep going out there and holding the other team. You're not giving them any cushion to work with, and that gets tougher and tougher as the game goes along. Put the ball in the end zone and get sixes. That's the ambrosia that they're looking for.
Ambrosia, and trying to erase this deficit. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40.
Now that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back, maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
And they'll run on the inside handoff. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5, to about the 39.
What's going on, brother? I done gave us 2 big plays on defense, man. I got caught slipping, bro.
Make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Third down, Corral. He gets this one to Hubbard, complete. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
Well, they certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
And not able to break away this time, as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's 2nd and 13. Right back to Hubbard. And he's taken down after a gain of 3 as they move it from the 22 to the 19.
That was a particularly nice play, because not only was it his job to force the play inside, he was actually able to fold inside himself and make the tackle ultimately. Very nicely done.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I didn't have the ball in the red zone 3 times, man.
One time thus far in this game, so you can see the frustration starting to come out a little bit. Third downs, they've been a problem for them all game. They've got to start becoming solutions.
This is up and good for Sonero, and that'll get the lead down to 5. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number 1. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
Offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown.
Williams loses the football.
There we go. I was about to say, bro, come on now. Pick up the ball.
Preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Hey, first down, they'll go to the ground attack to the 27-yard line.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
From the 27, Corral. And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's third and six. Corral from the gun on third down here. And he will find his big tight end over the middle. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Here's a quick throw caught by Smith. Touchdown, Panthers!
Oh, that's one right there.
Shai Smith, his first touchdown on the year. And the Panthers have taken the lead. Eddie Pinheiro down for the extra point. And the lead is now 2. The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Charles, you got to think the number one goal here is ball security. Remember, last drive they coughed it up. Then they allowed the touchdown, and now they're trailing on the scoreboard.
Boy, the way you described it makes me think that that one actually hurt them 3 times. The fumble cost them potential points. Then they watched their opponent get a touchdown off of the fumble. And third, they lost the lead as a result. Really tough sequence right there. I don't think coaches have to remind them to hold on to the football. They've just got to find a way to get it done.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. On play action, they'll throw. He's airing it out for Williams. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Jeremy Chin picks it off. And he's trying to push the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
He's got the connection to Moore. Touchdown!
And leave DJ one-on-one.
DJ Moore, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Panthers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And that makes this a 9-point game. The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away. Offense ready to kick off their next drive.
And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Sliding out of the pocket.
Good job.
Can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down.
Good job.
Multiple players combined for their team's 1st sack of the game. That time, finally, a measure of revenge as they get him down behind the line.
It almost felt like relief, didn't it? Because with the success he's had throughout this game,
you'd almost expect him to get free and pick up 10 to 15 every time he takes off. Not in that case. That has to feel good for the defense.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And connecting here with DJ Shark. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now a timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. They go play action here on first down.
Bro, it wouldn't even let me sack the quarterback, bro.
Oh, that's good decision making right there. Understood down distance.
Man.
Knew it wasn't third down, and he still had another opportunity to earn the first down. Good job throwing it away and avoiding an interception.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Down, he'll drop to throw it. They try to find Shark, but it's intercepted.
Fourth ball, bro.
Chin picks it off, and the Panthers are going to have it here just past the 25.
And Brandon, how many times have we talked with these rookies out there, and then we finally hear from them that the game slowed down and they're able to handle things? Not so far for this rookie, because right now, back-to-back drives, they picked him off. Not college football anymore.
Skitter.
He's got to find a way to handle what these defenses throw.
Started off low, but looks like we
So it's halftime here in Charlotte with the Panthers out on top.
Play some defense. Bryce Young is fast.
Coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports halftime report. Coach. Welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. It'll be Lions football to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports.
Appreciate everybody, man. Tuning in. Legendary E-League, week four.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they're down on the scoreboard. Sort of a sloppy first half. Coach Davis, if you were in the locker room, what would the message have been?
I think I'd have to go with something you
make them burn it down the field, fellas. Make them burn it down the field.
That's a fire and brimstone. You've got to fire these guys up. Make them understand what's going on out there. They were so sloppy in the first half. Too many turnovers. Tighten things up. Maybe get in their face a little bit. Get in their grill. And then send them back out.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. That pass caught. It's Williams. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 22 yards there, a first down.
And that's a nice catch there. Remember, he had the fumble earlier. No way he was giving up the ball in that situation. Secured it tight to his body.
This team really good. I got to pick my spots, man.
Here we go.
They run the option here on first and 10. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. Second and 9 now. And that's to Amon-Ra St. Brown. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 38-yard line. 13 yards as the quick slant keeps the drive moving.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And a very determined run there as he'll take this all the way down to the 27. Good effort. 84 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
Down at the 25. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Here's second and 8. They'll find Williams on the slant. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10.
Slant route.
And mark him at the 5. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there, because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Come on, bro, not on J.J. Watt, man.
The average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Second and goal from the 6 this time. Now here's the option play going left. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. He'll get 2 on the keeper, but it becomes now a 3rd down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you expect it to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits.
Oh my!
A great effort there. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Lions are back within a score. The point after is good, and the lead is down to 2.
The fact that he threw that.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. But Charles, they still have the lead despite their defense giving up a touchdown on the previous possession. And even though they have that lead, it feels like a back-and-forth ball game where to try to get momentum back.
Man, I'm right there, man.
Hey, I could have said the same thing, bro. How you just threw that? I could say the same thing. You just threw that ridiculous pass in the end zone right there. Actually, I just took that one away from him.
Try and make sure that that momentum stays in your camp.
Out of the gun, here's the give to Hubbard. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Second down, another chance for Hubbard.
In the bush. And a good hole, man.
And he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. 13 yards, first down, Panthers.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Corral to throw on first and 10.
What the fuck? He's got it.
He's got a touchdown, Panthers. A great play there with his first career NFL touchdown. And they're able to add on to their advantage. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And that makes this a 9-point game. The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away.
Oh,
Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They did what they had to do to start this third quarter. Went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started at halftime.
Yeah, you're exactly right, Parker. They had a little bounce in their step after scoring that first touchdown, but the defense gave one up, and that's the problem right now. Can they get better play from their defense while they continue to score on offense?
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 99 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries. He continues to be effective running the football, a big reason that they have the lead.
And I love one of the quotes that I read about him where he said of himself, I love it when a team just hops on my back and I just carry them along.
Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third.
The plan was clearly to challenge them by sending a blitz on second down, but even the extra guys couldn't catch him in the backfield, though. He didn't scramble for a first, but he does get the last laugh by evading the blitz and getting beyond the line of scrimmage.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now back to throw. The open man is Shark. It's complete. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they get 5 there on 3rd and 2. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 2. So both teams trade touchdowns in the third as we're through 3 quarters of play. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. There they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And he gets it down to the 32. From the 32 now. Here's 1st and 10. They're going to look to throw. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be 2nd down.
And this is a rarity in the NFL, a 100-yard game on the ground for a quarterback. Even as those passers get more athletic and mobile, we only see about 5 of these a season. It takes a special set of circumstances for it to happen, and of course, a special player.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to 3rd down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
They'll look to throw for it on 3rd and 1. He's got this complete to Williams. Yeah, he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. They only needed 1 yard on 3rd down. They get 10 instead by going to the air. From the 13 now, they work on 1st and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Open man right side is Shark. call it a gain of three on the play, and it'll be second down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
7 yards left for second down. Ball at the 10. They'll drop the throw. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete. Well, that's a perfect example of how he was named NFC Defensive Player of the Week from last week's game. He is just all around the football right now, isn't he?
That he is, and it's funny because I talked with the coaching staff about drills that they do in practice, and one of them is called matching hands, and as soon as that hand is launched by the...
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. It's their quarterback. His third touchdown of the game, number 9 on the season. And the Lions have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they've seen their lead nearly extinguished after that last score, but bottom line, they are still on top with the football, and a touchdown on this drive would really put them in position A. They'll start on the ground with Hubbard, and not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground, keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
On second and 9, Corral. That's going to be caught. It's Chenault. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. Panthers on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 9. On third down, Corral. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he's going to come up a bit short. He needed to get to the 35 for the first, but he only makes it to the 34. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
They'll run for it. This is Foreman, and he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 32. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on fourth.
Well, they didn't accomplish their goal. They didn't get a stop there and gave up another first down. They have all 3 timeouts in their pocket. I think defensively, you got to start thinking about using them here.
I was just going to ask you, at what point do you think now's the go time?
I think now's the go time. I don't think you sit back and wait, because they can take a lot of time off the clock between plays and run 3 to 4 and really put you in a stressful spot.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's across the 45. It'll be second down.
It may be only a gain of 3 yards, but that back, he deserves a lot more credit on the play. That could have easily been stopped at the line, but his vision and his determination found some space to turn it into that modest gain.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Off play action. Here's Corral. For Marshall, that's complete. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. A game there of 30 big ones. A big plays back and forth just continue. Both offenses excelling.
And I hear the excitement in your voice while you're calling this game. This hurts my soul as a defensive player watching these teams go up.
He's got it for a Panther touchdown. For the touchdown, and the Panthers get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Pinheiro's extra point up and good, and that makes this a 9-point game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I'd warn against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out, but I don't think there's any worries with this group right now. This is a hungry group, and they want to keep building off of their last drive. Now they just want the officials to hurry up and place the ball so they can snap it and get back to work.
Okay. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. They'll set up a throw. That's complete to Moreau, the tight end. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First down, Detroit, 16 yards on the pickup.
Oh, a lot of credit to the play caller here. He saw the design in his mind and implemented it. A little zone stretcher here because they started the tight end on the left side of the formation and set him on a crossing route. And this works really well when you can find that space between levels, and they were able to do so for good yardage.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. They'll look to throw here. Out to the left. That's where the tight end Moreau is. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
That's a good-looking play to me. The big tight end on a crossing route coming underneath. Sometimes he can gain some serious momentum going forward, can he?
Yeah, he can indeed, and pretty well executed there. On first down, he'll drop to throw. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game.
But defensively on the previous play, they gave up a pretty good chunk of yardage, but right there, they got a good portion of it right back.
And if we just flip it around from the offensive perspective, took a nice step forward, and how about a couple of leaps backwards after that play? They've got to figure out a big call coming up here to try and gain that yardage back.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield.
How, bro?
Taken in at the 5. And he takes this how? Into the end zone. And all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit
I backed tighter. Him up, bro.
And what a throw that was, Charles. You think about the situation. Close game, fourth quarter, rookie quarterback. He doesn't seem phased one bit.
So much for bright lights, big city, and will he wilt? Not at all. The stage not too big, the moment not too big at all. They needed points on that series, and not only did he produce a touchdown drive, but how about finishing it off with a big play that only adds to the momentum that they've already established.
And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that. Just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics will tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't
all
you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. 10 yards is the pickup there, and that should just about put a bow on this one. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he
ain't never seen a game where you back your safeties up and they still get burned. And they got good speed. I could see if it was some scrub back there, man. I've never seen football game like this. That's wild. Like I said, I could see if it was some scrub that was back there. That's Jeremy Chinn. Like, fast as you don't know what, still getting beat on crossing routes that they said that they fixed. Man, this game is bad. This game is bad.
So this one is
real
over, a victory for Carolina. And we talked so much about the turnover battle determining who wins and who loses. This game, no exception. They didn't turn the ball over at all, and they go on to victory.
They looked like a smooth operation in this one, didn't they? Because you look at every facet of the game, they handled their business. Offense took care of the football, converted it into points. Defense took the ball away, gave it back to the offense. Special teams right there with them. That's the type of game a coach is going to really love and value. And when they show the film, they have to be careful not to give out too many kudos and kill their motivation going forward.
I mean, we got the win,
so
man.
The Panthers,
good Lord.
That early momentum continues here as they move to 4-0.
And Bryce Young, I think Bryce Young is too fast, bro.
Meanwhile, for the Lions,
I think
whoever
made these rosters
two.
For the draft class,
try to get
bro,
back in the swing of things next week on the road.
He was out running everybody. Bryce Young had 115 yards. Record off read options. That's wild, man. That's wild, bro. Yeah, this was a wild game, man. We got the win, though, but God, dog, bro. Okay, this is what I'm talking about, bro. Look how far my safeties are, bro. I got them backed up. Why would he do that? Like, why would he? See, that's bad programming on EA, man. And then he lets him go right by him. Look at that. What DB, what safety you know get taught that? Look at him, he just freely gives up his leverage right here in palms, man. It's like, bro, the only thing you can run is man-to-man defense now, bro. Look at that. He just let him go right by him. It's terrible, bro. This game is terrible, man. J.J. Watt win. This game is bad, man. This was a heck of a dot right here. I had to get Matt his 300 yards right here. Preformed it too. Good throw, man. I almost got it, though. Free for him and put it over his shoulder. Yeah. Look at this boy. Now you tell me, how does he catch the ball right here? How does he catch this? Look at that, man. Look at this. How?
That's ridiculous, bro. Ridiculous, man. Animation, man. Animation is trash, bro. That was a dumb throw. I ain't no Chan had two picks. This is a wild game, man. The rookie out here be making plays, though, bro. Look at. Oh, he just threw him down. Make him fumble. This is a good draft pick by me, man. He couldn't play that. He attacked the ball. I thought it was going to play me right there. Good job by him. This is the one that picked. Look, Bryce Young was gone, bruh. I think he too fast, man. That made Bryce Young too fast, bro. Yeah. We gave up two big touchdowns, really. And we picked like three field goals in the first quarter. Like in the first quarter, we got like down there three times. But it was a good game. Credit to him. He played really well. It's like we got some rewards. Somebody got hurt. But we pick up the win, man. I appreciate everybody for watching the stream, man. We'll be back. We approve the 4-0. Legendary E-League. We rocking the Panthers. And we're looking good so far, man. We got to shore up some things. But overall, I feel okay about the team. We got to get that pass rush going. But when you're playing against, let's take a look at Bryce Young's stats, man, because his ratings. Because I think he's a little too OP, bro. Like, for real. Yeah, 89 speeds is OP. Yeah, they made him OP. Yeah, he way too fast, man. That made him way too fast. He got a squad though. Like, these receivers ain't slow, bro. That's why I ain't play much cover three or no palms or anything like that. I wasn't trying to get beat deep. So I try to play man and just keep everybody back. But again, I appreciate everybody for tuning in, man. We're going to go ahead and wrap up the stream. Y'all have a good one, man. Enjoy y'all day.